Good afternoon, this is Isha Sood, and the third panel consisted of Mr. Piyush Manush, Mr. G. Sundarajan, and Ms. Bhargavi S. Rao, who was chairing the panel. The panel gets a great kickstart with Mr. Piyush Manush debunking Sadhguru back in 2010 and 15, where he claims that he had apparently built lakhs of trees for the Kaveri's betterment.
That was shocking also. Then one fine day came to Salem, 2015, January 5. All boats all over. Rosaiya, the governor, is planting the 9 lakh tree. Not going to plant 9 lakh trees. He's going to plant the 9 lakh tree. Well, we're surprised. Where is the trees in Salem? Salem is a small place. We would know. People would have called me. I want to water it.
Mr. Piyush tactically proved that Sadhguru has been deceiving his followers by rechecking that the trees were actually never built.
Let me call spade a spade. Not done, boss. You are lying to the world. Kaveri calling, he said, I will not touch one single paisa of Kaveri calling. There's a board, separate board formed with Kiran Majumdar, TCS chairman, XISO chairman. Where is that board? We went to the registrar office in Coimbatore. No board is there. All the money from 42 rupees till the crores that he has collected has gone to Isha Outreach, of which he is the chairman. We have a trust deed with us. All the money from 42 rupees till the crores that he has collected has gone to Isha Outreach. Lies, lies, bundle of lies. How can any civic society think of partnering with such lies? It's not possible, it's not done.
Methane, hydrocarbon, crude oil, all of these ruining Kaveri. 4,000 acres of land lost, production going down, Kaveri Delta sinking. All of these are what is leading to farmer suicide.
And Delta is sinking. The Krishna Goya Delta is already sunk. And the Kaveri Delta is sinking. In 25 years, according to Janagarajan, you will not have Nagapattinam district at all. Presently, large areas, large regions of Nagapattinam district are below the sea level. So, you know, it is completely sinking. Kaveri will not flow by just planting rivers. Unless Kaveri calling talks about the extractive industries, including methane, hydrocarbon, Kaveri will never flow, friends. And out of the sand that is bucket for the entire state of Tamil Nadu, 50% of the sand is mined from the tributaries of Kaveri. Amaravati alone gives about 35% of Tamil Nadu's sand requirement. Amaravati is one of the major tributaries of Kaveri. So unless we are going to talk about the extractive development, we are not going to get Kaveri flowing, and we will only see things getting worsening. Because why, you know, last year in June 5th, our Prime Minister Modi got the International Environment Award. While they gave it to him, that's a different thing, we'll discuss later. He got the International Environment Award. In that function he spoke, you know, Mitro, we have spoiled this earth. In the last 150-200 years, we have used fossil fuels like hydrocarbon, methane, nuclear and coal, and we have spoiled this earth. And from now on, we will start using energy sources that are above ground. All these years, we have been using energy sources that are below ground, and from now on, we will use energy sources that are above ground like solar, wind and etc. On the same day, his government signed contracts for 50 oil wells with Vedanta in Tamil Nadu. On the same day, in the last 8-9 months, the government of India has signed 272 hydrocarbon wells only in Tamil Nadu. Only in Tamil Nadu. You know, ONGC says that, you know, they drilled about 700 wells, whereas PCB is having data for only some 15 or 16 wells.
The panel chair, Ms. Bhargavi S. Rao, concludes by urging the society to do their bit and wake up and stop extracting the natural resources.
Judicial level, in terms of our court orders and judgments and the legal provisions, I think we all need to wake up and do our bit to stop this madness of the crazy extraction. I know on the other hand, you know, the simple glass sitting here will need sand, my cell phone will need sand, but somewhere we have to draw a line to all kinds of extraction. Thank you.
When one of our reporters asked Ms. Bhargavi S. Rao if banning the extraction is the right thing to do in a developing country like India, her response was,
I think all kind of extraction should be banned because that is where the river originates. So if we don't do anything there, then we won't have any river flowing. So for example, there, you know, people have shifted to coffee plantations, people have shifted to other different kinds of livelihoods, growing of arecanut, growing of silver oak trees, growing of
different kinds of other things. So here are some traditional knowledge going back to our old ways of living, conserving that catchment area like we've been hearing since the morning. That has to happen, and in those areas I think it has to be declared like a no development zone and complete ban of all kinds of extraction. So if you walk along the river Kaveri, we have hundreds of such smaller hotspot areas, ecologically sensitive areas, and all in all those areas I think we have to have buffer zones. There are there, it's not that it's not there, it's just that we are not mindful of it. We've been violating all those rules, so there has to be some kind of very strict regulation.
Thank you so much for watching. I am Isha Sood with cameraman Yash Raju.